Okay, so here we go. We have our passes, and all we're going to do is we're going to take it, we're going to insert it right here, pop back out, and fast pass drops. And you can repeat that with all your park tickets. Once we go through all of them, your fast pass will come out, and it says that you have a return time from between 1:20 and 2:20. That's when we can come back. Afterwards, we can fast pass again after 12:20. Until we can return to present our fast passes and go on the ride, we've taken the opportunity to come over here to Test Track. Test Track is currently shut down right now, but it's an opportune time to explain another way how Disney keeps their lines going. Disney offers three options on this particular ride, and they do this on other attractions too. Select ones. They offer the standby entrance, which is typical of most theme parks. They offer the fast pass entrance, which you would have to obviously present your ticket to. They also offer a single rider option here too, which is key. Which keeps, if you want to look over here, you can see the three different lines that you can wait in. But this really keeps things going, which is perfect for people. Cart comes through to the exit, they have all the guests get off there so that when the cart proceeds to the next part of the stage where the line actually is, everybody can get right onto the line or right onto the ride. Completely empty, you don't have to worry about mishappenings of people getting on and off. It's completely clear. Right here we have a sign, and the sign actually has posted the waiting times for all the rides throughout the park. Now this is located off of the central hub of the park, and they have a few of these scattered around throughout Epcot. Another really, really interesting thing is if you have an iTouch, and I don't have one on me right now, but if you have an iTouch, you can download a free app where anywhere you are inside the park or on property, you can find out the waiting times of every ride within the park. That also really helps out guests throughout the area. We're going to head over to the Seas right now, and the Seas is really interesting because we're going to step on a queue line that really isn't a queue line. It's actually a ride, but it's what will move you into an entire pavilion. So we're going to head on over there right now. All right, this is a really neat opportunity that I've gotten. They gave me an activation key, so that means I get to carry this throughout the line with me. What they do before we actually head onto the line is they would step over to a little nifty thing over here. This is the activation port, so they swipe it right in front of it, and then the guest who receives this would carry this online, and as it goes through the line, we would get to eventually the end and hand this off. We would hand this off to the next person before we got into the attraction, and that would keep track of the time that we spent on the queue. That's a way that they can monitor how many people are on there and how long it's taking. That's how they can predict how much time to put on the board so that guests know how long they're going to be, you know, waiting online. All right, let's go. All right, here we go. We're going to hand in the card. To get inside the actual building of the Living Seas right now. So we are moving the entire line along by being on a ride. So this is the best in queueless queuing. So let's keep watching Nemo and Dory.
Hi, I'm Dory.
I am looking for my son.
Oh, I can help.
This is also another perfect time to record because we're online. We've been online for like 20 minutes for Test Track. They're back and open and running. But it doesn't even feel like that because we're online and it's an interactive line. So this is Disney's concept of queueless queuing, basically. Is the line is part of the ride, basically. And we're going to get up to the actual entrance, but we're going to have to go through a briefing room and then go on to another line. But the briefing room seems like it's part of the ride. So they eliminate this whole concept of, oh my gosh, it's dragging on and on and this is terrible and whatnot. And even in the bathrooms here, we just made a bathroom break and like my aunt was telling us about like what it's like in the bathrooms. And hold on 1 second. You wanna tell them?
Hi. Bathrooms are fantastic here. They put the stall all in one row, and then they break up the sinks into groups of three, then a half wall, then three to the right, and three to the left. So the ladies aren't stepping over each other to get to the soap, or the towels, or the garbage cans. It was a pleasant experience to go into the ladies' room here at Disney.
Exactly. That's it. See? Perfect. Fast passes are closed down. All the tickets have been distributed. We've made our way around the park. So now let's go on in and hand in our fast pass. Let's go.
Guys, think Billy's coming back?
Nah. Probably right.